Hello, hello, hello. Welcome to another episode of the TasCast Show. This is episode 46, and I hope you guys are enjoying the episode so far. Today's episode is a bit special. It's the first episode that's gonna be it's gonna have a vlog or a video, YouTube video basically going alongside. I hope you guys enjoy. And today basically the difference is gonna be that the topic of the videos is to answer questions from entrepreneurs, from marketing questions, or related to data questions, whatever I can answer, whatever I feel like I can answer to the best of my abilities, as I was explaining, as I'm explaining later on in this video as well, in the video as well, I'm gonna try my best to answer those questions. Now, hey guys, so just setting up the camera there. I don't really have the tripod, so try my best to put a good angle without the need to have a tripod. I'm gonna be recording the podcast as usual, but this time I'm starting a YouTube series again, like proper video. I've been thinking for a while. Let me remove the camera, the equipment. Anyway, I've been thinking for a while now how I can incorporate videos that don't require too much work, or to be honest, not much work at all almost, to edit and make sure that I continue producing my podcast and offer value, something that may not exist in the market yet, from a video point of view, from a vlogging point of view. So my idea, I came with an idea last night, and I was like, you know what, straightforward, tomorrow I'm going to do the first video to deliver the content that I thought of delivering last night, and here I am. I'm gonna be delivering at the moment one video a week. So for every three podcast episodes, I'm gonna be recording one video as well. So it's gonna be a richer content distribution, and hopefully over time, let me see if it's like the length is not straight. Yeah, I think better now. So over time, hopefully I'll increase it to more videos. But for now, I want to deliver one video a week, making sure that I deliver some sort of value. And the value that I want to deliver is actually, I'm looking for questions that entrepreneurs might have, or data scientists might have, and answer them to the best, to the best of my abilities and knowledge as possible. Now, I found a couple of questions. I was looking on Twitter and I was looking on Quora. I didn't find anything I liked on Twitter or on Quora. I mean, I need to do a bit more research, I think, on Twitter to find the kind of questions I'm looking for. But because I have the privilege to be one of the founding members of the Startup Race, and one of our products is the League of Entrepreneurs of Slack, so it's a Slack community, and Uber accidents, yeah. It's a Slack community, so what I'm doing there, I'm answering questions, that we have questions from entrepreneurs that I can answer. I can answer it in the form of video, like this one, for example. Now, I'm just gonna record. So, this is pretty much what this video is about. And I'm gonna be answering two questions, and I'll be moving to the questions in a moment. So, question number one. Question number one I picked up a question from one of our Slack members. His name is Andrew Hobbs. So for you, the podcast, the Slack group is the League of Entrepreneurs, and our members are entrepreneurs and investors. And we have events like Ask Me Anything events on the channel. But people can ask questions in the community, and which I try my best to contribute. And with these videos, actually, I'm going to try my best to even answer more questions. Or if you have any questions on social media, just let me know on Twitter, and I will be answering. So Andrew Horst asked on our Slack page, he asked that he noticed the MRP channel. MRP stands for Minimum Revenue Product. And he's asking, what's the difference between a Minimum Revenue Product and MVP, which is Minimum Viable Product? He continues to comment, although I completely accept that selling something is the gold standard in market validation, I think you can go too far in focusing solely on revenue and deform your value proposition and other aspects of what needs to be tested. And I see where you're coming from, Andrew. I see. So I hope you watch this video, man. If you watch this video, let me know if you like my response. But I think this is viable for most entrepreneurs out there who are starting a new business or trying to test a new product. Yeah, the difference between minimum revenue product and minimum viable product. Basically, minimum revenue product, I came up with this term a couple of years ago, after failing a couple of times as an entrepreneur. And the main problem is everybody was pushing me to test my minimum viable product, give it away for free, and develop it based on what the customers really want to consume or buy, etc., etc. I agree with the main principle of the idea, but I don't think it works for most ideas, because what's happening is as soon as you ask for money, the conversation changes. So initially, you give it for free, people are like, yeah, that's exciting, that's so nice, I love to try it out, oh, I love your product, oh, would you add this feature as well, let's say if it's a software or whatever, and they'd be all over it. But what's up with when you ask money, what's happening when you ask for money, people are going to probably be, oh yeah, maybe if you add this feature as well, or maybe, I'm not sure. So yeah, initially when it's free, people are going to try it out, they're going to tell you they love it. It's a lot of bias sometimes, or a lot of fake news, let's say, as real fake news for a business, because what's happening, basically you want to make money from your product, from your service, or whatever you're selling. And you find it difficult to make money even after so much positive feedback. And that's not because people are mean or bad or liars. It's not a lie, basically. It's a psychology of the consumer, yeah. If the barrier to getting access to a product is low, like zero money, then you're more likely to just invest some time and use this product and like it. But if you have to spend money to buy something, to use something, then that's when you start really considering, all right, does it worth the time? Does it worth the money? Am I going to actually use it? Do I actually need it? And all these questions are becoming more relevant as soon as you add a price tag on anything that you try to sell. It might be a service, it might be a product, whatever it is, people think differently when you add a price to it. Now, we don't say though, don't use an MVP. A minimum viable product you can use in the beginning. So your MVP should take no more than 2 weeks to figure out, in my opinion. 2 weeks is even long. So your MVP could be a questionnaire, it could be your first touch with the customers to showcase the concept of your idea. Get this feedback, and then as soon as you get initial positive feedback without offering a product or service to them, the next thing you do is prepare your minimum revenue product which means you start selling whatever it is you want to sell. Is it a product or is it a service? If it's a product, your minimum revenue product would be maybe an Indiegogo campaign or a fundraising campaign, that, because you don't have the product yet if it's hardware. So just run a campaign on a fundraise. That's an MRP with an MVP, because you don't really have a product. Your MVP is your video, let's say, and your concept. And your MRP is your promise to deliver that concept to the customer. But that's when you sell. And that's your minimum revenue product, because you make some money before you have the product. You make some contracts, you create clients. And that's essentially a minimum revenue product. It doesn't need to be something that you sell directly. It can be, but it has to be something that brings you money in. Yeah. At the startup race, the League of Entrepreneurs is part of our MRP. We want to help entrepreneurs grow, start, and avoid the mistakes that we did and other entrepreneurs are doing, connect with investors, help entrepreneurs any way possible, basically. And to do that, it requires time and resources and connections and everything. But we started from the League of Entrepreneurs slowly, filling a gap. We saw over 100 people signing up in just 7 to 8 months, to a year. And then we see, okay, people are looking for a community to help them out radically succeed and become investment ready. So that's a cheap product, but we generate some revenue. It covers some of our basic expenses. We don't get paid as founders, actually, from that MRP, but we know that people are buying into our concept, into what we offer as a service. And we are growing now with investment ready in Esprit and other products. And eventually, our final product and our proposition and our biggest value is coming later on. But first, we need to prove that, you know what, people are buying into our concept. People are using and getting value from our products. And that's basically the conversation we're having with MRP and MVP. I hope you are satisfied with this answer, and I hope you enjoy it. But now I'm just gonna move on to answer one more question. And I hope you, Andrew, I hope you enjoy it. I'm gonna share it. I'm gonna tag you on Twitter, so hopefully you're going to see it. If you like it, just share it. It's up to you. I'm gonna also share it on the Slack community. As a response, maybe more of the community members would benefit from. And the second question I'm gonna move on to now.